channel. In case if you are new in this channel, please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. And if you are my return subscriber, thank you for coming. You are wonderful. Please don't forget to like this video, share this video out to your friends. So guys, in today's topic, we are going to discuss on the issue bordering marriages in Europe. Here with me in the studio is Mr. Tony. Mr. Tony, you are welcome.
Thank you very much, Nancy Morgan.
So, Mr. Tony, what do you have to tell my fans?
Yeah, I've been watching your TV show and I feel that it's a very good one. So I urge you guys out there to come and watch and also comment in the comment section.
Okay, you guys have heard it. So guys, in today's topic, we'll be discussing about the issue bordering marriages in Europe. So Mr. Tony, can you deliberate on this issue? Can you maybe you just give us four major problems that bordering marriages in Europe?
Yeah, thank you very much, Nancy Morgan. Thank you once again. Actually, there are many issues bordering marriages, not only here in Europe, in other parts of the world. You understand?
Yeah.
So, for us to cut the matter short, we can be able to deliberate on four major aspect of it. Okay, let's say, for my own personal opinion, I believe lack of respect.
Yes.
Is part of it.
Yes.
Financial problem.
Yes.
Lack of understanding.
Yes.
And also lack of planning.
Yes.
So these are the four major factors we need to consider before propagating any form of marriage.
Yes.
Okay, at this juncture, I want to take lack of respect.
Yes.
Lack of respect. We understand that marriage without respect doesn't work.
Yes.
There must be a sort of a mutual respect to both parties.
Yes.
In order to propel the marriage to the highest place. So if you are a beginner, you must conquer dicks into marriage. It's something compulsory.
Yes.
You must have to put in marriage.
Yes.
Make sure your party, two of you, are in mutual respect.
Yes.
So that is for that. In that of financial problem, you know, you cannot set up a foundation without planning.
Yes.
So at this juncture, planning a financial problem, you have to make sure at least you acquired a little kind of something.
Yes.
that will be sustainable, that will be sustaining the marriage.
Yes.
Understand me? So at this very point, financial is very important in marriage. You understand me? Marriage is not something you have to build on a business foundation. So you must have something to support. Just like you need to train your children, you need to take them to school, you need to feed them, you need to care for your wife, you need to care for even external family as well. Because in marriage, so many things attribute to failures. So a financial problem is something, if one want to embark marriage, have to deal with. So the third one, which is planning.
Yes.
Planning is very, very important.
Yes.
You have to plan, set up a plan. And that plan should be between you and your
partner.
Because if you plan only, the other, your fellow might look at it, not some tension to carry the marriage to the highest place. So which means you have to plan along with your wife or your fiancé. So by so doing it, when there is no money to finance whatever you people have planned, at least your woman can be able to show understanding, noticing that in times to come, things will be moving well. So that is for planning. So in case of understanding, which is the last one.
Yes.
So that one is very, very important. You cannot do without it. As far as marriage is concerned. Because with understanding, every part of the marriage characteristics will work well. You understand me? Because there are so many peripheral problems, that are around marriages. So with understanding, you can be able to subdue these very problems. You can use understanding to subdue the problem of lack of finance. You can use understanding to also subdue lack of respect.
Yes.
You understand? So that is why understanding is very, very essential in marriage. So yes. That's where I can end for now. Because there are so many things. If we continue, maybe tomorrow we'll finish it.
Let me ask you this question. You said earlier that in marriage, that you have to have enough money before you marry. Yeah. Okay, does it mean that if you don't have money that you cannot marry?
No, you see, there are two different kinds of people misunderstood it. You understand me? That's why people who want to embark on marriage have to undergo what is called a tutorial course in order to, you know, tell them the challenges. You understand me? What I mean by buoyant, you know, if you are buoyant physically, which is the physical cash we see, you understand me, is a big advantage. Then if you are buoyant, maybe you are good in thinking, making things positive. You understand me? Is another aspect of finance. Because you cannot have money, but you can think. You understand me? Being able to derive something out of nothing matters in marriage. Yes. And that is what woman is looking up to a man. If you have money, it's a big advantage. Whereby there is no money, but you can be able to think of something and make it work positively. Now, woman can depend on you. But whereby you cannot derive something out of nothing, you just stick on your side, woman is feeding you, marriage doesn't work like that.
But some people, it works for them. Like people, they will be, you will see in a marriage, that will be the woman that is feeding the family, but it doesn't mean for
you see, that is understanding. You understand me? Maybe the woman is working, is opportune to work. Yes. You understand me? But if a woman is feeding a man, there still be problem and lack of respect will
occur.
Sorry
for interruption. What kind of problem?
The problem is that woman doesn't endure believing that one day man will embark on duty.
But not all the women.
Hey, it depends on understanding, which I am telling you.
Okay.
You understand me? If the woman doesn't understand in that form, believing that you are the pioneer of the marriage, you pilot the marriage, then, and you are not doing well, definitely the marriage will have a problem. You understand me? So the best way of making marriage a functional one is let the man have something doing.
Yes.
You see, the man will command respect at the highest level. That's what I think.
That was African understanding. Because here in Europe, all these white people, as in the in Africa, let me take Nigeria as an example. Now when you take a girl out, maybe you take a guy out to, you tell the girl that you want you guys to go out for maybe for dinner.
Yes.
So when you guys eat finish, the girl will be expecting you to pay.
The man to pay.
But here in Europe, everybody can pay. It's not a must, and the must that is the girl that's supposed to pay for us, or the boy that's supposed to pay for us. Here in Europe, anybody can pay. But in Africa, they have that mentality of saying that man must pay in everything.
You know, civilization and culture differs. These are different two things. You see, a typical African man is highly cultured.
Yes.
Then a typical white man is highly civilized.
Yes.
You see the differences now. Yes. So these people you called white, they understand the fact that everybody must participate in the routine. They must take a routine in the things of marriage. They must work. Everybody is equal. But in African culture, we believe man is the one who have to feed. So with that phenomenon now, women now believe taking them out is the duty of a man.
Okay.
You understand me? Have I made myself
Yes, we have made yourself
clear. Okay.
Okay, in terms of respect, who have to respect most in marriage?
Yeah, that's another good question. It is reciprocal. Respect is for the two parties.
For the two parties.
Yeah, you don't say because you are a man in the house, you don't respect your woman. No. You get it wrong. You must respect your woman, and your woman must respect you. Not all those kind of, let me call it a deceptionist. There are some kind of deceptionist in the midst of marriage. You know, some people, some women, they'll respect their man inside, outside. They don't respect, they want to showcase that they are the head.
Have you experienced that kind of thing?
Yeah, there are so many cases, you know. I've said so many cases based on that. You will see a woman, mm-hmm. you will call her husband, darling, you know, respect, not only that, you know, participate in every activities of home. But when it comes to her side, you know, start shouting, which is not right. If you want to correct a man, you have to be disciplined.
Yeah.
You understand me? Because man is an actioneer. He have this very, you know, proudness.
Yes.
He's a proud entity. They like to protect their dignity when it comes to public things. I made myself right.
Yes, thank you so much, Mr. Tony. Thank you so much. I really appreciate having you here today in my studio. Guys, you have heard it all from Mr. Tony. So, if you have anything that you want us to discuss or talk about in our next video, you can drop it in comment section. This is the end of our video. See you guys in our next video. Please don't forget to share this video out. Give this video thumbs up. See you guys in our next video. Bye.
Bye, you guys.